led by the Minister of State for Transport, Fred Byamukama, officials from the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority interfaced with the Parliamentary Committee of National Economy, which is currently reviewing performance of government projects funded by loans. The delegation was to showcase the performance of the $200 million loan which was acquired from the Export-Import Exim Bank of China in 2016 to upgrade and expand Entebbe International Airport.
Upgrade and expansion of Entebbe International Airport, phase one. These projects, we are the employer, the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority. The financier is the Exim Import Bank of China. The consultant is Darahandasa.
The loan was secured to provide infrastructure and facilities at Entebbe International Airport in order to accommodate current and future traffic. However, it has suffered delays.
Contract period were extended, determined extension period, determined revised completion period. Is this without any cost implications? We want to know so that we can compare with your what you have given us on page 6. If you include the actual.
Okay.
Honorable Chair.
Chair, the third component is the strengthening of runway 1735.
You have said the construction of the new passenger terminal building.
Yes.
The reason why it delayed is because of the cargo.
Yeah, because
we need it to be clear. What are you?
Because where we were having the cargo. Mm. Is where we are putting the terminal building. So we must first shift from that area to go to the new cargo center in order for us to start this construction.
As of now, UCAA has completed the strengthening of the runways and its associated taxiways, strengthening and expansion of apron 1, 2, and 4. Cargo centers and cargo building additional civil works, among other facilities, have also been completed.
This loan came as one. In the first place, phase one was one, and the components are construction of a new cargo center, and this is reported to be completed.
But committee members rejected Uganda Civil Aviation Authority submissions on grounds that they could not explain the amount spent on different infrastructure and the specific works accomplished with the aid of the loan.
So what we needed here was, like he stated, the new cargo center has been completed. What is the cost? What is the status? Then you move to the next activity, you make that presentation. Because don't present to us what you want, because you have been the one implementing.
These additional gimmicks to confuse, engineers and accountants use to confuse people when there is something on ground that is not clear and perfect.
Let us hear
my information that this is intentional.
Updated project cash flow. Why don't you provide us with the actual?
Correct. Correct.
You have given us all the other columns. Where is the actual?
So if you are in a class and the lecturer is teaching, you're not understanding what is teaching. So what some students do is to actually walk out so that, and I don't want members to walk out that they don't understand. So that's where the problem is.
After a disagreement, the presiding chairperson, Robert Migade Ndugwa, decided to turn away civil aviation officials to organize themselves and account properly to parliament.
We are discontinuing a presentation by CAA, and we...
Chair, I seek your indulgence.
We will go with the another agency which is ready. CAA seems to be unready. And when you are presenting PowerPoint, especially where you have even achieved that this is complete, you also present pictorial. That's normally how PowerPoints are. You show someone who is not there what is actually.
Chair,
that's the purpose of
PowerPoint. Is supposed to be powerful.
Yes. Oh, they have been dismissed. Honorable Macho, please serve the minister.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.